Oh, hello. My name is Mara, and welcome to Books Like Woe. So, I was looking through my list of YouTube video ideas that I had, and I was kind of doing some sorting, and I realized that I have a lot of ideas about series. Either, like, thoughts about series, lists of series, just a lot of things about series. So this is going to be my series. the first of which you guys have already seen, which is reasons why I have DNF'd series in the past. So I've already sort of started this, but this is like me letting you know I have a lot of ideas for videos about series, and this is the first one, and appropriately, since it's kind of the first one, I wanted to talk about first books in series. Now, I kind of brought this topic up in the Buddy Reads chat that I had going with the ladies for when we read Truthwitch back in April, and I kind of posed this to them, and they were like, oh yeah, definitely make this video, and they had some good thoughts. So basically, kind of my question to them was, what is it that you really expect a first book to do? And the reason that question kind of came up for me in that particular read is that Truthwitch is an okay book, but a very, in my opinion, promising beginning to a series. So the series isn't done and I've not continued yet in the series. So like, I can't tell you for sure that I can forgive its flaws because of where the series ends up going, but I suspect that that's what this will be. And I think there was somewhat of a divide in that Buddy Reads of people who just enjoyed this period, like, just thought it was good. People more like me who said, like, I don't know that this is that great of a book as a standalone, as a single entity, but, like, I'm excited for where this series might go, so, like, I'm into this enough that I'm okay with it and willing to give it some grace. And then folks who are just like, no, like, this book just doesn't work, so therefore, like, I'm not interested. So anyway, this book kind of like brought these thoughts to the fore, and I was kind of thinking, like, so the question of this video is basically like, what is it that we expect a first book in a series to do? And I have a lot of thoughts about this, so hopefully this will be somewhat organized. Hopefully future editing me can like make this all come together. But kind of my first point here is that I do have very different expectations for a book if I know that it is the first book in a series. Now, sometimes I've read books, and we'll get to a couple of these, where I didn't know it was the first in a series, and when I realized that, I potentially even liked the book less, but I approached it from a standalone aspect, and then when I realized that it was a series, it kind of changed the way I thought about the book. So like, that definitely kind of lets me know that when I know that a book is a part of a series or the first in a series, I definitely do think about the book a little bit differently. The kind of second point in my thinking about this is whether or not it is a serialized series or an episodic series. What I mean by that is that serialized series, which is repetitious, sorry, have a story slash plot arc that is very purposefully meant to span a number of books. Trilogies are usually this way, and you are not really getting a complete story in the first book. It is very much like part of a bigger picture. Episodic series tend to be more episodic, so there is continuity between the books. Don't get me wrong, it's not that like each of them is an island unto themselves, but there's a lot less continuity there, and there's not necessarily an overarching plot that connects all of the books together so much as you are usually just sort of following the same group of people or the same world or whatever as they progress. Just to concretize this a little bit, so like a great example, or like a classic example of a serialized series or a serialized trilogy, is Lord of the Rings, right? Like, if you just read The Fellowship of the Rings, you're going to be kind of like, okay, what the fuck, where are we going from here? And actually, so much so that Tolkien actually originally envisioned this as one book and had to split it up into three because of paper shortages at the time after World War II. So that is like classic, like, these should not be read by themselves, like they are meant to tell a bigger story. In contrast, most like mystery series, most are more episodic. So, like, Poirot, for example. You guys know how I feel about Poirot. Definitely an episodic series. So, there's sometimes contradictions. There's no, like, in terms of, like, what has happened in the past. You definitely don't have to read those in order. Like, you can kind of jump in wherever you want. And, you know, there's some changes over time. But in general, they're meant to be read as standalones that have the same recurring cast and the same kind of plot type over and over again. And a lot of mystery series are this way. Something like the In Death series, I think, kind of straddles this line. So it, because it's a mystery series, so it definitely has that kind of like crime of the week episodic feel to it, in terms of it's not that there is one kind of question you're trying to solve or like makes progress over time, but in general it's not like there is some like big villain that the heroine is trying to defeat in that series. It really is her solving a variety of crimes week to week to week, but you have the same characters, and like I said, there is kind of one question that I think sort of thematically unites them, and you definitely are seeing a lot of like character growth and development over time. So even if it's not plot-wise serialized, I think character development-wise, that one has more of a serialized feel, and therefore I would be more hesitant to tell you to just jump in wherever in that series than I would be for something like Poirot. So anyway, those are kind of the two different categories. And most of this video is going to be talking about serialized first novels and like what those need to do. And I will just, like, before we jump into that part, for episodic first books, I think what those need to do is get you interested in the type of plot that that series is going to have. So, like I said, a lot of these I think are mysteries when we're talking about episodic series. I can't think of a lot of episodic like fantasy or romance. Okay, I'll take that back. Romance has a lot of episodic series to it, where one couple gets together in the first book and then another couple who you met in the first book gets together in the next one. So there is some continuity, but they can mostly be read as standalones. So mystery and romance have a lot of like episodic series, and I think what those need to do, like I was saying, is get you excited about the characters and get you excited about the plot type and kind of the world that those episodes are going to take place in. So I would think of that much more as something like a Law and Order or Criminal Minds or whatever on TV. Those had to get you excited about the characters, the plots that you're gonna have on a week-to-week basis, and like the overall sort of like premise. So that is kind of what I expect from an episodic first book. But most of this, like I said, is talking about serialized, so let's get into that. So when we were talking in that group chat I was mentioning earlier about what a first book needs to do, I think Leanne from Leanne's Library really summed this up very nicely, where she basically said, For her, the book both has to succeed as a entity unto itself. So it has to set up promises and deliver on promises for the book, but it also has to set things up that can't get resolved in that book and want you to keep going. I think that's very nicely said in terms of like, in theory, ideally, what a first book in a series should do. I think if you were like taking a writing class, that is what they would say, is like, okay, you need to like set up some things in the first book. Like, you essentially need to have like a mini arc in the first book and set up the macro arc for books going forward. What I've realized though, when I've been thinking about first books and kind of like what I expect them to do, I'm a little more forgiving than that. And this isn't for everyone, I'm just talking about for me. I am much more, for a serialized series where I am not going into it with episodic expectations, if it's a serialized series, what I want it to do is get me excited for subsequent books, more so than having an awesome first book. So, like, I mean, I'm a little bit lenient, and two examples of books where I don't know that the first books are as successful as maybe I'd want them to be, but both of these I still rated 4 stars, and both of these I would want to keep going in the series with, are Truthwitch, which is what spurred this, and this is one that makes me want to continue from a plot perspective, so I am interested to see what is going to happen to these characters. I also really like the world building, but even more so than the world building, for me in this one, the plot and the characters were set up in such a way that I'm interested to see what happens to them. And kind of also fantasy, and on a similar note. In this one, I mean, I like the characters, don't get me wrong. I enjoy the characters, and I am intrigued with the plot, what's going to happen with this. But more so than anything, the world building in this got me really excited. So the premise for this was well set up enough that even though I think this had some pacing problems, and I don't know that it was the best... in terms of a first book, I just enjoyed the world building so much that, like, I didn't care about that. And I want to keep going in the series. So in both of these cases, these are books that I was pretty lenient with in terms of, like, does this book work as a thing unto itself? In both cases, probably not, but knowing that they're the first in a series makes me much more forgiving of them as a first book, and therefore just as a book in general. I would like them more than I would have if I thought they were standalones, if that makes sense. So that leniency just sort of like has made me mull on the thought of like, am I too lenient on first books? Because I really do think I'm someone who gives a first book in a lot of ways the benefit of the doubt. Like I expect that any issues or questions that I have are gonna get resolved later. Now, that probably makes me a harsher criticizer of the end of series. Like, there's very few series, because one of the video ideas that I wanna get to eventually is series that I think, like, nailed the landing. I'm having a really hard time coming up with series for that, because I do tend to be pretty harsh about, like, okay, I gave you a lot of grace up front and, like, leeway to take me where you wanted to take me, and you didn't do a good job. But anyway, like, I guess a question that I've been mulling over is, can a first book fail as an individual book but still succeed because it's the first in a really good series? And I think that I do have a couple of examples where I think that's the case. One of which is my favorite series that is going right now, which is the Kate Daniels series from Ilona Andrews. I think that this book... I'm about to reread this because the final book is about to come out, so hopefully I can add that to my list of series that stuck the landing. But anyway, this first book has some real problems to it. Like, I think that the world is really cool, like, and the more you learn about the world, the cooler it gets. But I don't know that they knew yet how to, like, efficiently and effectively communicate how cool their world building was, like, on a writing level. I think that this is very much a first book in a series and an early book from very talented authors. And I actually wasn't going to continue in the series because the plot was fine, but not amazing for me. And same with the characters, they were all, like, fine, I liked them, but it wasn't, like, really hooking me in. It wasn't until I accidentally read the prequel novella that they wrote later that I was like, oh my god, like, I love this main character, and the world is so cool. But actually, like, so this is one where the first book, like, I didn't have as much grace on it, but, like, ultimately it does get really strong, and it does go really interesting places, so, like, now when I look back, I can say that I have a lot of grace for this, probably because I know what's going to come. But at the time, it was like, it actually worked okay as an individual novel, but it didn't have enough to make me want to continue on in a series. And I mentioned Tolkien earlier. I mean, he's another one where The Fellowship of the Ring, I barely got through that the first time I read it and was like, I don't want to keep going. Like, this is not fun. I don't understand what's happening. Like, I can tell there's a lot of world building going on, but, like, I'm having a hard time following it. And granted, I was in high school when I first tried to read it. I was probably in middle school, actually, when I first tried to read it after I read The Hobbit. And I was just confused by it, and it made me, like, not want to continue. So in that case, like, I don't think Fellowship of the Ring is a very successful first book. But once the movie came out, actually, and, like, I watched it and understood what the world building was and, like, knew who the characters were, I flew through the rest of those books. Like, I reread Fellowship of the Ring and then flew through the rest, because I was like, oh, this is amazing. But anyway, both of those are examples where I think that the first book actually does kind of fail. But that doesn't mean that it's a bad series. So, like, in that sense, it makes me feel like, okay, well, you can't always judge a series by its first book, but you, for serialized series, you have to start at the first book. So, like, when I'm recommending the Kate Daniels series, I always tell people, like, try it, like, get, if you like the first one at all, keep going to the second. If you don't like the second one, then, like, maybe stop. But, like, get through the second second book, because that's where it really starts to get good. And something like the Psy-Changeling series by Nalini Singh, that's a series I really like. And the first two books I think are fine, like they're pretty good paranormal romances, but I don't know that they're anything super special. The third book is where shit is like really good, the characters are really compelling, and the world opens up a lot more, I think. You can kind of see how great this is going to be from like an arc perspective in terms of like all the political machinations that are going on and whatever. But you have to get through those first couple of books. So like the first book in a series can be really hard to recommend if it's not the strongest one, especially if it's a series you love and you really want people to keep going with it. It's very hard for me anyway to be like, yeah, just go read that. And I always want to give the disclaimer of like, it gets so good, stick with it. Like, even if it's not bad at first, I always want to be like, it gets amazing. Like, wait till it gets amazing, please. Like, keep reading. I think another pitfall that first books can fall into for series is that they can be too conclusive and therefore not work as a first book in a series, like really work as an individual book, but not necessarily work as the first book in a series because it doesn't make you want to keep going because you feel like you have an ending. So it's sort of the opposite of those other ones I was mentioning where as a part of a bigger story, it really works, but maybe not so much as an individual book. These are ones that I feel like are good as individual books, but bad as a part of a story because it doesn't make you want to keep reading. So like I've actually had a few of these recently. The Queen's Rising, I think I talked about last month, which I really enjoyed this book ultimately. It is slow to get started, but ultimately really enjoyed the book. I cannot tell you where the series is going to go because I feel like all the questions I had have been answered and I might keep reading, but it's not compelling me to keep reading because I feel like a lot of my questions have been answered. And I think part of what a first book in a series should do is answer some of my questions, but leave me asking more questions that I can't wait to have answered. And I just don't know that this book did that. I also think that The Hazel Wood, I didn't know that this was the first book in a series. I think I alluded to this earlier. And I love the ending of this book. I actually really, really love this book. And I love the ending of it. And now that I know that it's the first in a series, it actually makes me like it a little less because I like the ending of this. So I'm hesitant to keep reading because I don't know that I want to have that ending spoiled for me. So I think in some ways this works really, really well as a standalone, but I'm not sure how well it's going to work as the first in a series because I don't want to keep reading it necessarily because I liked the ending. And then The Name of the Star. This is another one that I think could be read as an individual book. It's the first in a series, I think called The Shades of London. And I actually might recommend that people do read this as a standalone because I think the series doesn't necessarily go places that are that great. So yeah, I mean, this is one that I don't know works that well as the beginning of a series because the expectations that it sets up are not met, in my opinion. I think where the series ultimately goes doesn't really align with the kind of book that this is. Another example of that, by the way, is Hunger Games. Like, I think that it works. I think that the promises that are set up in that first book, I don't think are honored in the conclusion. And therefore, I really like The Hunger Games as a standalone, but I don't like that series as much because I don't think that the author set up a fair contract with the reader in the first book. And I would say that that's similar to this, that both of those are ones where I'm like, the first book as part of a series sort of fails because it's not actually setting you up well enough for where the series is going to go. But as an individual book, like as a standalone, it's really interesting. Conversely, I do think that books can be too cliffhangery. So, you know, there's the problem of the books I was just talking about where it doesn't make you want to keep reading at all. And then something like Truly Devious by Maureen Johnson, I think somewhat is not a very successful first book because it does absolutely make you want to keep reading, but I think it does it in a way that is not entirely satisfying because the book leaves you on a cliffhanger and not enough was happening in the rest of the book that it feels like, well, this was just a preamble to get to the part that I really care about. So this is the one where actually, I mean, I'm fucking intrigued and can't wait till the next one comes out. This is the one where I most kind of align with what Leanne was kind of saying about the first book needs to satisfy its own questions and then leave you wanting more. I don't think this first book had enough questions unto itself, and was basically like a really fascinating introduction to the next two books in this trilogy, and that's where most of, I think, the meat is going to be. This is one where I think I align most with her criticism, because in general, like I said, I'm pretty lenient about that stuff, but this was one where I was like, I think that this doesn't work enough as an individual book, even though I'm super excited to keep reading in the series. The kind of a counterexample to being too successful as a standalone book. Okay, so just a couple of examples of first books that I think, just ones that I had on my shelf, basically, that I think work really well as sort of a setup book. First, I think Every Heart a Doorway. So this is somewhat serialized and somewhat episodic. It's one of those ones that sort of is in the middle. But I think this does a really nice job of setting up a really interesting world. I think it has a very strong voice. It establishes characters who you are excited to see again. So when you do see them again, in at least the next two books, you're excited to learn more about things that are hinted at in this first book, and to really like dig in with those characters. So maybe I should think of this as more of an episodic one, but it kind of straddles the line. I do think it's a really successful first book though. Again, another one that kind of straddles the line is maybe a little more episodic, Forgive the Man Titty. This is just what we have to deal with when it comes to terrible romance covers. But The Iron Duke, this world is fucking interesting. And like, this is like steampunk adventure romance, and it is really, really fun world building. I think a really distinctive writing style that I really love, and characters who you definitely see throughout the rest of the series. Again, I think this is one that straddles the line, because it is somewhat episodic, but I do think that there's some questions raised in this one in terms of like what is going to happen to the world writ large that continue to be addressed as the series goes on, and if she ever actually finishes the series, because there's one book that's supposed to come to finish things out, I will be interested to see kind of where things are left. So I think that this does a really nice job specifically of setting up world building and setting up mood. And then the last two are definitely more like true blue serialized things. Now, one of these is a series I have finished, and one of these is a series I have not finished. I'm in the middle of the second book. The one that I've not finished is A Darker Shade of Magic. I think that this book maybe suffers for not setting up enough interesting questions. One thing that I'm realizing is that first books in series do tend to be really padded often and don't have enough going on in them, just because I think that the author is wanting to kind of get world building going, which is great, but I think sometimes that's at the expense of, to Leanne's point, having enough questions in the first book. I think this somewhat suffers from that, but I think in general it does move along pretty much at a nice clip. The world building that does happen is super interesting. I think that this definitely answers the questions that it does raise, and I think that there's enough meat for the size of this first book, and absolutely leaves me intrigued and wanting to know more about the world and know more about what is going to happen to the character. So I think this is a really good like first book in a series, at least in my opinion. Actually, one that I don't have in physical form, I have it in ebook form, is The Agency by Y.S. Lee. I don't think I've ever talked about that series on here, but it is a historical mystery series that is YA, and it's about teenage girls who are saved from death row in Victorian England to become spies. It's awesome. And I think that first book does a really nice job of setting up the recurring characters. There are definitely some like bigger questions that are happening in those books that the heroine is trying to solve, especially about her dad and like what happened to him exactly. And yeah, I think that that is a really great first entry in a series. And then finally, another one that's very serialized, definitely falling on that end of the spectrum, is The Natural series by Jennifer Lynn Barnes. This book, I think, does a fantastic job of, it is Criminal Minds YA, basically. So it nails the episodic piece of a series in terms of this is a very satisfying entry in the mystery that is set up for this book, but it also clearly sets out the arc that's going to happen. And once you know how the series wraps up, you can definitely see like her, I think she knew endgame from this book, or was a very close reader of her own text to take advantage of things that happened in the first book to really have a very satisfying ending. It sets up a four and a half, there's a novella, book arc that I think is really just tight, well done, well paced. Every book in that series I think is good, like there's no duds. And this first book just sets up everything that happens after it. So I think this is one of the best first books in terms of thinking about it as, does this work as a first book in a series that I've ever read, because it satisfies its own questions and absolutely does a great job of setting up the rest of the series. So yeah, I think that will do it. I hope that I'm able to make that coherent and somewhat of an actual argument instead of me just rambling about random thoughts I have about first books and series. But definitely let me know your thoughts below. Are you someone who's pretty forgiving for a first book because you kind of are expecting it to do some like setup? Are you someone who really wants it to like work on as a thing unto itself? What are some examples of good and bad first books and series? Just let me know your thoughts below. But yeah, I think that will do it. If you enjoyed this video, please like, subscribe, follow me on the social medias if you are so inclined. I have all that information listed in the description box below. And I will see you guys later for more videos on series, because I have a lot of ideas about ones I want to do. Anyway, hope you're having a great day, and I will talk to you later. Bye!